First and foremost, congratulations on your album. I know that it just dropped, right?
Yeah, in June, 21st of June.
Yeah. Lovely.
How's it been going?
It's been overwhelming. It's funny because it's my second album, right?
Sure.
I should be calmer. I should be less afraid. I should be less daunted by society.
Mm-hmm.
I'm probably twice as nervous now.
I agree, definitely. I totally get that.
Yeah, with the success of your first album,
it's probably even more nerve-wracking,
right? I'm completely like, I don't know, I'm always like stuck, like I don't know what to do, like, I don't know how to feel, but so far people have loved the album.
What is different in this album? What are the things that you did differently from the first album? I mean, a lot of people would say you don't fix what's not broken. I mean, your first album went double platinum,
first of all.
I mean, like something like over 40 million views, 40 million streams, something along those lines.
Million screams.
Listen, you've done so well in your first album, and I totally understand why you'd be even more nervous about this one.
Yeah.
But to your fans out there, to new people you're trying to get, talk us through the new album. What have you done differently? What remains the same?
I think what remains the same is, okay, so I'm a strategist in general.
Love that.
I like to plan everything. So with Kings of Mar, there were a few tracks that were placed there, I think four tracks. The kids who've listened to it and the adults who've listened, they'll understand what I'm talking about. There were four tracks that kind of indicated to Monarch, right? I designed them in that way. I'm the executive producer of all my music.
Fantastic.
So I do not allow someone else to tell me what to do in studio. You can advise and stuff. So with this album, I had even more control.
Beautiful.
With Kings of Mar, there were a couple of things that I felt like could have been better. I know it went a double platinum. I'd wanted it to go triple. You know?
Okay.
So, So you're like, it's a denied.
I think every single person wants more for themselves.
Yeah.
And with Monarch, what I decided to do is carry the flame that I started with Kings of Mar and just kind of make the sound even bigger, you know? I sat through so many grueling sessions in studio and it was painful. I cried a lot. I was criticized a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But this time I had so much more control and a lot of people didn't understand the music. I've seen on social media how people are like, oh, she should have used, you know, these people from, and I'm like, look, I'm growing. Unfortunately, I'm not a stagnant person.
Mm.
So when it comes to music as well, I look at music as a growth thing.
Sure.
You have to keep growing. Kings of Mar was not broken and it will remain unbroken as it is.
Yeah.
But we have to grow from that. And Monarch for me is like a step closer to where I want to go. It's like my primary school phase is done. This is high school now.
Sure.
You know, we're going to get to tertiary. We're going to get to the working world. I've just begun. And I understand that a lot of people don't understand that. They feel like because I've achieved so much, you know, so this should be...
On Monarch, like, who did you work with?
Oh, the people were amazing, first of all. I had three writers that assisted me. I usually don't get assistants.
Wow.
It was, I don't know his real name, and he's like very close friend of mine. DJ Choice, Moonchild Sinelli, and Msaki.
You worked with Moonchild?
Yeah, they're amazing writers, and they each have such different personalities when they bring it onto paper, you know? So I needed those strong voices. And then I also worked on production. I worked with Noble Beatmakers, made up of Bubele Boy and David Belshore. I also worked with DJ Choice. I worked with Calvin Fellow from Pretoria.
Mm-hmm.
I worked with Simba Tags, DJ Camera, Mr. Camera. Oh my gosh, Evita and Blazon.
Yeah.
Oh, I feel like I'm gonna forget. So
what are you hoping for in terms of your fans' response to your new music? What did you want this album to say about you and your journey?
That I'm a proud representative of music that is South African and African. I want people to understand that I'm not here to just be about myself. I'm making music for people. I make music for their lives. I've gone through so much and I feel like I'm not alone in this. Whatever it is that I've gone through, people have gone through the same things. And I need people to hear these stories and I need South African music to grow outside of SA, mm-hmm. you know, and I've tried in my very minute little power, you know.
It's not my
way.
Mm-hmm. 43 million streams is not minute. You have
but
done.
I'm trying.
You've done phenomenally well, and your music is such a beautiful representation, not only of you, but of the South African music industry and where it could be. And that's what's so exciting about your music. We wish you all the best.
Thank you.
We cannot wait for your performance at the end of the
show.
Thank you.
What show are you performing later on?
This is Love.
This is Love.
It took us 8 months to create that song.
For real?
By the way.
What? Is it hard to find love?
Trust me. I want you to know.